Welcome to DBForge Studio for MySQL tutorials. DBForge Studio is a comprehensive all-in-one IDE for developing, managing, and administering MySQL and MariaDB databases. In this video, we will talk about foreign keys. The foreign key constraint, as well as the primary key, is crucial to relational database design. They are both used to enforce data integrity. To watch the MySQL primary key tutorial, please follow the link in the video's description. And now, let's focus on the foreign key. What is a foreign key? Why is it needed? And how does it work? If you want to receive new MySQL videos regularly and learn how DBForge tools for MySQL can simplify your workflow, like this video, subscribe to our channel, and click the bell icon to get video updates. Stay up to date with the latest news in the database world with the DevArt channel. As you might know, primary keys serve as identifiers in a relational database. They comprise a column or a combination of columns that contain values that uniquely identify each row in the table. Foreign keys, in their turn, work as a linkage mechanism between two tables when a column or columns that hold the primary key value for one table are referenced by a column or columns in another table. This column becomes a foreign key in the second table. In other words, foreign keys allow you to establish relationships between tables. They are set on a column in a dependent child table and point to one of the columns in the main parent table. Typically, a foreign key points to the primary key in the associated main table. If we go deeper and consider the foreign key from the point of view of the database table, then the foreign key comprises a field, or rather the properties of a field in the table. These properties determine what kind of values can be added to that field. All this is the foreign key mechanism. All in all, foreign keys allow you to cross-reference related data between tables. The foreign key constraint identifies the relationship between a parent table and a child table containing the column values that refer to the parent column values. A foreign key is defined on the child table. It provides a reference to the data in the parent table and guarantees the referential integrity of the data between the two tables. This way, the foreign key helps keep related data consistent. On a technical level, in MySQL, foreign keys are implemented through the constraints mechanism. Database constraints are, in fact, rules enforced on the columns of a database table. These rules are used to limit the type of data that can be added to a table. Thus, constraints ensure the accuracy and reliability of the data in the database. Like primary keys, foreign keys can be created with the help of the create table and alter table statements. The essential syntax for defining a foreign key constraint looks like this. Let's take a closer look at each operator in this syntax. Roughly speaking, there are three logical parts in the syntax: identifier, conditions and restrictions, referential actions. Let's consider each one in more detail. Identifier. The constraint symbol value is used if it is explicitly defined. Otherwise, the constraint name is generated automatically. The symbol parameter is optional. Conditions and restrictions. This block specifies a table that our table will refer to build a link. Referential actions determine how the database will react to data changes in the parent table that has matching rows in the child table. In other words, the referential actions specified by the onUpdate and onDelete subclauses of the foreign key clause determines what actions should be done to keep data up to date in the child table if the data in the parent table undergoes changes. Let's look at the possible referential actions. Restrict and no action reject the delete or update operation on the parent table. Both work similarly to omitting the onDelete or onUpdate clause. No action is a keyword from standard SQL. In MySQL, it is equivalent to restrict. The MySQL server rejects the delete or update operation on a parent table if there is a related foreign key value in the referenced table. In MySQL, foreign key constraints are checked immediately, so no action is the same as restrict. Cascade deletes or updates the row from the parent table and automatically deletes or updates the matching rows in the child table. Both onDelete Cascade and onUpdate Cascade are supported. It should also be noted that Cascade foreign key actions do not activate triggers. The setNull action, as you might guess, deletes or updates the row from the parent table and sets the foreign key column or columns in the child table to null. However, in the case of several operations of this kind, the link between the parent and child tables may get lost because matching values will be set to null. The set default action is very specific. Its usage is limited and nowadays is not recommended. It is recognized by the MySQL parser, but in most cases is ignored or rejected. We also need to mention a few important facts. For storage engines that support foreign keys, MySQL rejects any insert or update operation that attempts to create a foreign key value in the child table if there is no matching candidate key value in the parent table. If no action is specified for onDelete or onUpdate, the default action is always restrict. A foreign key can be defined when creating a table. The syntax for this is as follows. A foreign key can be added to an already existing table. The syntax for this is as follows. To delete a foreign key, use the following syntax. Such an abundance of theoretical material requires serious practice in order to better understand how the foreign key mechanism works. Let's try to put this to practice and look at the specific examples of usage. For this, we will use the DBForge Studio for MySQL development environment, which allows you to run SQL commands in a classic, terminal-like way, and at the same time provides a user-friendly graphical interface, convenient for both experienced and novice developers. The work examples will be demonstrated on the Sequila sample database, designed to represent a DVD rental store. For better demonstration, we will create an empty database and call it Sequila. We will perform all the manipulations on that database. To view the structure of the original Sequila database, please follow the link in the description of this video. Okay, let's get started. We have already connected to the MySQL server and created an empty database. As we've already mentioned, the foreign key is closely related to the primary key. To learn more about primary keys, please follow the link. As an example, let's consider the following situation. These are the city and country tables, which may already be familiar to you from the primary key video. The city table, as its name implies, contains a list of cities, and the country table, respectively, holds a list of countries. Let's create these tables. Each table has a primary key. Suppose we need the database to store information, which city is in which country. Thus, we need to link these tables together. For this, we will use the foreign key mechanism. If you carefully look at the structure of the tables, you can see that the city table already has a field for linking with the country table, country ID. We've created it intentionally for this purpose. In DBForge Studio, you can create a foreign key in several ways. For better clarity, let's do this using the database diagram functionality. Here, it can be done quite easily by simple drag and drop. Now click Apply Changes. Effortless, right? As you can see, the foreign key has been successfully created. There is now a relationship between the city and country tables. In this case, the country table can be referred to as the parent or main table, and the city table as the child or subordinate table. And now let's go back to the moment when we created the foreign key and walk through the process in more detail. As you can see, when creating a foreign key, DBForge Studio for MySQL opens a special window where you can check and configure table constraints. On the General tab, you can find the name of your foreign key. If necessary, you can change it. Below, you can see the foreign key relationship. The country ID field of the city table refers to the country ID field of the country table. On the Advanced tab, you can set the referential actions for the created foreign key. Click the drop-down to see the available options. As already mentioned, restrict and no action are identical in functionality. Further, we will take a closer look at how these settings can affect the data and what you need to pay attention to. If you click the Script Changes button, the SQL script for creating a foreign key will open in a new tab. Here, you can change it if necessary and then execute it. This comes in handy when you need to assign a specific name to the constraint. To execute the script, just press F5. When you create a foreign key, an index is automatically created on this column in the table. This greatly speeds up the process of extracting data from this column. DBForge Studio for MySQL has a very convenient mechanism for adding values to related tables. When adding or modifying the foreign key data in the data editor, you can not only select a valid value from the list, but also view the values in the parent table. This helps avoid errors when inserting data. Now let's look at a practical example of how the referential actions for the generated foreign key can affect data. This example will use the already familiar city and country tables and a small set of test data. We have created the tables. Let's create a foreign key again. As you remember, it can be created by simple drag and drop. On the Advanced tab, we set the referential actions for our foreign key, no action, for the delete rule, and restrict for the update rule. Now click Apply Changes. Perfect, the foreign key has been created. Our tables are empty. Let's fill them with test data. The data set is small for clarity. The country table has only two countries, Australia with country ID 8 and United States with country ID 103. The city table, in its turn, contains seven cities, one of which is Sydney, relates to Australia, while others relate to the United States. Now let's change country ID for Australia from 8 to 999. When trying to do this using the visual interface, we get an error. Now let's try to delete the record using a SQL query. And we get the same error. This is the result of the referential actions configurations we set earlier. As expected, the reaction to the update and delete operations is the same, the error, although we set no action for the delete rule and restrict for the update rule. To change or delete data in the parent table, if there is a related foreign key value in the reference table, you will need to perform additional manipulations. In our case, to delete a record with country ID 8, Australia, you must first delete Sydney from the city table, and only then will you be able to delete Australia. And now, let's consider another example. For this demonstration, we will use not one, but two city tables, City 1 and City 2. Let's create a foreign key for City 1 and set Cascade for the delete and update rules. For the City 2 table, we will select the Set Null option for the delete and update rules. Oops, we got an error. To make this possible, we will need to remove the not null constraint from the country ID column in the City 2 table. We make the necessary changes and repeat the steps to create the foreign key and set the set null referential action. This time, everything has worked. Let's make sure that our tables are not empty. As you can see, the tables contain data. Now we will try to change the country ID for United States to 999. Everything's done without a hitch. Let's have a look at the linked tables. As you remember, for the foreign key in City 1 table, we set the cascade referential action. Now we can see that for all seven cities, the country ID field has been changed to 999. A cascading data update has occurred, which means that the changes in the parent table have been automatically reflected in the matching rows of the child table. Now let's look at the City 2 table. For its foreign key, we will set the set null referential action. As you can see, after we have changed the country ID in the parent table, the country IDs for seven cities now have nulls. The set null referential action breaks the relationship between the parent and child tables. These rules work for both the update and delete operations, so the wrong choice for a referential action may lead to data loss. Foreign keys are taken into account when creating queries using the Visual Query Builder. There is nothing complicated. Just select New Query and drag the required tables onto the workspace. If there are relationships between the tables, they will be displayed on the diagram and considered when composing a query. Let's select the columns to be used in the query and then run it. When viewing the table structure via Database Explorer, you can see the primary and foreign keys that the table has. Quite convenient, huh? The database diagram functionality of the Studio visually shows all the existing relationships in the database. If necessary, you can create a new relationship between your tables. A few clicks and you're all set. We sincerely hope that you found this tutorial helpful and interesting. Please leave a comment and share your opinion about it. We would really appreciate it if you liked this video and subscribe to our channel, where we publish lots of useful information. Share this video with friends or colleagues who study SQL or are interested in databases. We invite you to download a free trial of DB Forward Studio for MySQL and see for yourself that working with constraints doesn't necessarily have to be painful and distressing. Thank you for watching our video.